Hello friends, pattern is a very important part of mathematics. We can solve many questions with the help of patterns of numbers. Hope you remember the pattern of the table of 9. You have learned that when certain numbers or groups of numbers come repeatedly in sequence after an interval or else proceed based on a formula, it is called a pattern. The first thing we learn in mathematics is counting numbers, which is also a kind of pattern. In the previous video, you learned about the properties of square numbers. Square numbers also make many interesting patterns. Let us see some of their patterns. Look at these numbers. Are you able to see any patterns here in these numbers? You are absolutely right. These numbers are in increasing order. The difference between the first and second number is 2. The difference between the second and the third number is 3. The difference between the third and fourth number is 4. These are special numbers. They are called triangular numbers. Do you know why? Because they are numbers whose dot patterns can be arranged as triangles. Do you see any other patterns here? Let us try to add these consecutive triangular numbers. Adding 1 and 3 gives us 4, which is the square of 2. By adding 3 and 6, we get 9, which is the square of 3. We observe that consecutive numbers of this sequence combine to form a square pattern. Therefore, we can say that adding 2 consecutive triangular numbers gives us square numbers. Let us see how many numbers fall between any 2 consecutive square numbers. There are 10 numbers between the squares of 5 and 6. There are 12 numbers between the squares of 6 and 7. There are 14 numbers between the squares of 7 and 8. Thus, if we observe the squares of 2 consecutive numbers, we can see that the number of terms between them is equal to twice the smaller number, such as there are 12 numbers between the squares of 6 and 7 and 14 numbers between the squares of 7 and 8. We can also say that between the squares of numbers n and n plus 1, there are 2n numbers which are not square numbers or non-perfect square numbers. See, wasn't that interesting? Now look at the sum of these consecutive odd numbers. Do you see any pattern here? You are absolutely right. Adding consecutive odd numbers starting from 1, we get a square number. This square number is equal to the square of those odd numbers. For example, the sum of the first 3 odd numbers is 3 to the power of 2, and the sum of the first 8 odd numbers will be equal to 8 raised to the power of 2. Thus, we can say that the sum of the first n consecutive odd numbers is n square. Here, we can also say that all square numbers can be written as the sum of consecutive odd natural numbers starting from number 1. Now look at the squares of these numbers as well. They make a very interesting pattern. Were you able to recognize the pattern of these numbers? You can pause the video and think about it. Yes, in these square numbers, we can observe that the number 3 in the original number comes as many times as the number 5 in the square number. In the square numbers, the number of occurrence of number 1 is 1 more than the number of occurrence of number 3 in the original number. With the help of this pattern, we can find the squares of the next number of this sequence without solving them. There are many other sequence of numbers whose squares form a very interesting patterns. Now look at these squares and try to identify their patterns. In this video, we learned about the pattern of square numbers. In the next video, we will learn to solve questions using these patterns. Thank you.